Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to all to online class conducted by Dr. Kasturi Government Girls High School, Chattogram. Dear students, all of you know me. I am your English teacher, Shireen Akhtar. How are you? I think everything is going fine with you. I am also fine by the grace of Almighty. Dear students, today I am going to discuss about punctuation. Most of you, I think, are known to this punctuation. Okay, dear students, have a look here. It's a dialogue. There's a dialogue between two girls, Raisa and Jakia. Read it. Raisa, what are you doing? Jakia, I am reading an article about global warming. Have you noticed that there is a significant change in world's temperature recent years? Raisa, yes. I have come to know from a discussion in Channel I, global warming is increasing day by day. How alarming it is. Okay. In the dialogue, full stop, comma, note of exclamation, note of interrogation have been used as punctuation marks. Okay. Now, the question is, what is punctuation? To make the meaning of the sentence clear, some tools or signs are used in a sentence. These tools or signs are called punctuation marks. Okay. In English language, the main punctuation marks are of 11 kinds. Number one, full stop, two, comma, three, semicolon, four, colon, note of interrogation. Next, number six, note of exclamation, seven, inverted comma, eight, apostrophe, nine, hyphen, 10, dash, and 11, brackets. Okay, now have a look here, full stop. Here are six sentences, first three sentences, go through. My name is Shaheen. It's an assertive sentence. At the end of the sentence, there is a full stop. Next, give me a cup of tea. It's an imperative sentence, and after the sentence, there is a full stop. May the Almighty bless you. It's an optative sentence, and after the sentence, there is a full stop. Each is a complete sentence, and after the one complete sentence, we use full stop. Okay. Now go through next two sentences. She is an MA. They live in the USA. Dr. Saim is a nurse person. MA, USA, doctor. All these are abbreviations. Now, after the abbreviation, we use normally full stop. Okay. Now, have a look here. Come to comma. Look at the first sentence. Mr. Shahjah Nuddin, principal from Dhaka College, was a very strict administrator. In the first sentence, here, a comma has been used in case of apposition. Next, Naila to the sum. Here, Naila has been addressed and she has been told to do the sum. Naila is an addressing word, and after addressing word, there is a comma. In the beginning of this sentence, there is an addressing word. Okay. Next, tell me, my dear brother, how can I help you? Someone has been addressed here as my dear brother, and it is at the middle of the sentence, and before and after these addressing words, comma has been used. Okay, next, to the work at once, Nasima. Nasima has been addressed here to do the work at once. She has been addressed first, and then she has been told to do the work at once. Nasima is at the end of the sentence, is an addressing word, and before this addressing word, there is a comma. Okay. Next, he said, I'm going. Said is acting here as the putting verb, and after the putting verb, comma has been used. Okay. Next, semicolon. We went to the playground. We played cricket. We enjoyed a lot. Okay. We went to the playground. There is semicolon. We played cricket. There is semicolon. We enjoyed a lot. Full stop. Okay. Notice one thing. In this sentence, there is no coordinating conjunctions. but we could use her word in conjunction. We went to the playground and we played cricket and we enjoyed it a lot. Okay, but instead of word in conjunctions, semicolon has been used here. We went to the playground, semicolon, we played cricket, semicolon, and we enjoyed a lot. Okay, now come to colon. Look at the first sentence here. There are two kinds of voice, colon. Number one, active voice, and there are two, passive voice. Why are colons used? Colons are used in sentences to show that something is following, like quotation, example, and explanation. Okay. Next, have a look. Here is a small dialogue. Here is a dialogue between two girls, Sumaya and Jamila. What they're telling. Sumaya, good morning, Jamila. Jamila, good morning, Sumaya. How are you? Okay. Can you notice one thing? After this speaker's name, here colon has been used. Okay. Now come to note of interrogation. Here are, look at first three questions. Where are you going? Where do you live? How did you do it? Here are three questions. Three interrogative sentences. After each interrogative sentence, note of interrogation has been used. Okay, now come to last sentence. Ika asked me what my name was. Here also a question in the sentence, but despite that, no note of interrogation has been used because this is not a direct question. He asked me what my name was. It's an indirect question. When there is an indirect question, there is no note of interrogation. After direct question, we use note of interrogation. Okay, is it clear to you? Okay, now come to note of exclamation. Here are two sentences. How fine the word is. What type of sentence it is? Exclamatory sentence. After exclamatory sentence, we use note of exclamation. Okay, next. Last, I'm done. Alas, this word, what kind of parts of speech it is? Interjection. After interjection, you always use note of exclamation. Okay. Now, come to inverted comma. Look at the sentence. Are you tired? She said to me. Here, are you tired? What is this? This is the reported speech. And before and after the reported speech, inverted comma has been used. Okay. Inverted commas are also called quotation marks, speech marks, and talking marks. Okay. Now turn to the sentence. Apostrophe. Here are two sentences. This is Lila's dress. Apostrophe is used here in possessive case. Okay. Next sentence. What's the matter? What is the matter? Here, I has been omitted. Instead, apostrophe has been used. Now, you're able to know why and where we use apostrophe. Okay. Now, come to use of hyphen. There are two compound words, mother-in-law, father-in-law. We use hyphen to connect different parts of compound words like mother-in-law, father-in-law, sister-in-law, brother-in-law, etc. Okay, come to use of dash. Look at the sentence. What is it? Carefully. If I had not lost all my wealth, dash. But why think of the past? A dash is used in a sentence when there is a sudden change in thoughts. If I had not lost all my wealth, dash. Then there is a sudden change in thoughts. But why think of the past? Is it clear to you? Now, one question may arise to your mind, that what is the difference between dash and hyphen? You have to notice one thing always, that hyphen is always shorter, dash is a bit longer. Okay, now come to use of brackets. I have lost all. Within bracket, I had a purse, 5,000 took with me. I have lost all. What I have lost? The information is in the bracket. I have lost highest purse, 5,000 taka with me. All this have been lost. So, brackets or parentheses are punctuation marks used within a sentence to include information that is not essential to the main point. Okay, dear students. Now I am going to give you homework. It's a homework. Use punctuation marks where necessary in the following passage. Here is the passage. Have a look at this carefully. You have to use your punctuation marks where necessary. The teacher said to Kamal, "Why are you talking in the class? You should behave yourself." Kamal replied, "Sir, I'm sorry. I'm talking Rahim to lend his pen. My pen has run out." The teacher said, "Be attentive and listen to my lecture. You have to do it." Okay, dear students, what we have learned today? We have learned a lot today about punctuation marks and their uses. Now you are able to use it properly and accurately. A homework is given to you. You have to do it, and I hope all of you are able to do it properly. After completing the work, submit to me in next class. You have to do it in the right time. Okay, now dear students, I am going to leave the class. Take care. Thank you all.